beforehand. I talked to you guys last time about the donation of blood and why people should donate. So today I'm going to persuade you to donate to any local or non-local blood bank. I'm incredible to talk about this again because I did many research on the topic, and I also have donated for 56 days, or every 56 days for the last 2 years, and I graduated high school at the Red Tassel because I donated so much, so I know a little bit about it. Have you saved a life lately? Why should you? I'm going to talk to you today about why you should donate, where you can donate, and who is affected by your donation. Previously, I told you that every 2 seconds someone in the U.S. needs blood, according to Michigan Blood, 2013, and 41,000 blood donations are needed every day due to accidents and traumas, and that's by Michelle 2013. So there's just a little, two big reasons why you should donate, because obviously we do continue to need blood. Who will be affected by your blood donation? I also previously told you that blood, your blood could save the lives of cancer patients, accident, burn, and trauma victims, newborn babies, mothers delivering the babies, transplant patients, surgery patients, and others in need. And that's according to Red Cross. So essentially, your blood is needed in every hospital at a daily basis. Blood it goes bad after 12 days of donating, so your blood is constantly needed because the timeline is so short. So other things, like when you donate whole blood cells or platelets, those last up to 56 days, so again, it's just always in constant need. Where can you donate? You can donate right here on campus. The campus news put out an article, and we are currently hosting a blood drive at CMU to see which university donates the most. So it's kind of interesting, especially because it is CMU week, or tomorrow, I guess. So that's Mercer who put that out. And then you can also jump in your car or bus and drive to Michigan Blood, and that's located on East Millam Ave in Portage and donate. So it's quite easy and really kind of cost effective. In conclusion, today I've discussed why you should donate blood, who will be affected by your donation, and where you can donate. There's also a story in January of last year, the Mets baseball team hosted a blood drive on Citi Field, and according to that writes Kay of the New York Times, he put that article out today, or last year. So it's kind of interesting because baseball players, football players, celebrities are not too cool to donate, so it's kind of a good inspiration for others to donate. So then I also have a short little video. Save a life, and it's really easy to, and it's the experience is awesome, and the feeling you have after is indescribable. So